Hi Venus, this is Srikant back again. So I'll be dealing the second part of microbiology, and I hope most of you are familiar with this because I made my best to expose you to all these tables from long back and just have a glance. Okay, so just have a glance, the difference between hepatitis A, B, C, D. Most common questions are fecal mode of transmission is present between A and E, the A's of occurrence. Okay, the A's of occurrence is again an important area. Carriers are most common in the case of hepatitis B. Okay, and there are many other things that you have to make a note regarding this. Okay, what is the type of virus, that is hepatovirus, hepatidinovirus, hepavirus, okay, and flavivirus, it's also called as. So please do make a note of all these contents, which are very, very important. Like, for example, carcinoma is malignancy is most common with, these are the two which causes the malignancy. Acute is, again, fecal-oral is common, and acute is common for A and D. I don't want to take much of your time. Just do make a note of the difference between the Australian antigen. What is the Dane antigen? Okay. So what are the sizes? Okay. Person who has given it. And coming to the carriers of hepatitis, hepatitis carriers are classified into super carriers. So what is a specific thing that you can find in super carriers? Please do make a note. Then you can make a note about the simple carriers. What are the laboratory tests for the diagnosis of hepatitis? And all these we have learned. What is HSB, AG, E, HBE, HCAG, that is C is nothing but core. Okay, so, and all this. The very sensitive one is PCR. Okay, so how this is going to change, they can ask you the question which is going to come first, okay, which is going to end last, and all these questions are most commonly asked, and I hope like you need to practice over this. Like for example, the patient is having IgM, okay, and positive for this, then it is an acute case, highly infectious case. For example, it is positive and IgG is late or chronic. Okay, so basing upon this, do practice this. We have learned so much or this in our regular sessions. And coming to this, the four overlapping genes in this genotype are S. So please do go through this. The next one is C gene, the next one is P gene, the next one is X gene. Okay, you have one or two questions over this in your regular MCQ books, and we have discussed this at our best during the regular sessions. Okay, the same goes, okay, how the genotype, how it's going to start, which is going to be present, your S, G, or X, and everything. And of course, this is HIV that you have to make a note. Okay, what is the structure of HIV, and what is PG41, what is P18, P24, okay, what spikes are made up of, and all these are very, very important. The reverse transcript test and everything. So this is what the nomenclature, that is enveloped proteins, they contain spikes, that is PG120, or the transmembrane pedicel protein, that is PG41. Your shell protein contains what, your core proteins inside contains what, your polymerase antigens contains what. So the next one is again the gene overlapping, the gene coding structures. What is gag gene, what is enveloped gene, what is pol gene. So all these are very, very important. Okay, all these are very, very important. And do make a note about these lines, okay, which are standardly recommended lines for disinfection and everything related to HIV patients. And of course, you're well familiar with this. Center for Disease Control and Prevention, USA, has grouped the HIV classification into group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4, and the different subtypes and categories. So what are long-term survivors or long-term non-progressors? Okay, about 5 to 10% of infected patients appears to escape from clinical features of HIV for more than 15 years. Such category of patients will be dropped under this terminology, that is long-term survivors. And the major opportunistic infections and malignancies that you can see in an untreated HIV patient. So what is the parasitic infections? What is the fungal infections? What are the bacterial? What are the viral? And what are the malignancies? The most common malignancy, of course, this question was, a diagram-based question was given in about Kaposi's sarcoma 2020. So what is gray bowel syndrome? Is a very common thing that you can see in the case of male homosexuals. Okay, so what is the difference between adult HIV and pediatric HIV? So please do make a note about all this. Specific tests which are useful for the detection of HIV, that is antigen detection test. Okay, the major core protein P24 is the earliest viral marker to appear in the blood, hence it is useful for early diagnosis of HIV. Okay, and followed by the IgM, similarly as in the case of your hepatitis B, followed by the IgG. So you can see this is the first, followed by G, followed by M. So please do make a note of all this, viral isolations, how you can detect and everything. Please do learn this. Okay, and of course the same inference as that of your hepatitis B. What are the specific markers for detection of hepatitis virus at different levels or different phases? Then for your sake, I just want to discuss few important aspects related to each virus. Okay, so we have already discussed all the case-based questions during our regular sessions, but I'm going to give the case description again for these things. Please do have a glance, because these are the topics which are common for both microbiology or oral path on oral medicine, your general medicine, wherever it is, the question can come from any of the corners. Okay, so like type 1 is called as HSV1, and type 2 is HSV2, type 3 is varicella zoster virus, type 4 is Epstein-Barr virus, type 5 is cytomegaly virus, type 6 is human B cell lymphotrophic virus, and type 7 is RK virus. Do make a note. And they can give you a case based question like hepatitis type 1, herpes simplex type 1 is above the abdomen and type 2 is below the abdomen. Okay, it is below the abdomen, right? I hope you're very familiar about that. And coming to the next one, they can give you a case-based question. For example, this is a case-based question which we have discussed long back on the group. That is a 25-year-old woman presented with a complaint of some ulcers like or blisters like on the genitalia. Okay, for previous 7 days, and fever, headache and vomiting in the last 2 days. On examination, she found to have neck rigidity and lumbar puncture was performed for CSF fluid. The CSF fluid was clear with a count of 1000 cells per cubic millimeter, and the lymphocytes were predominant, and CSF glucose levels are normal, and protein slightly elevated. The CSF was inoculated into cell line in the laboratory, and the PCR was positive for herpes virus type 2 DNA, and the patient was started on therapy with a particular antiviral drug. You can think of like any cyclovir, or you can think of cyclovirs, any cyclovir, and supportive therapy was also provided. The patient responded, and the patient would advise for the recount and the history of the doctor at after further pregnancy. So this is what the case description is. The case description clearly shows that all the treatment plans, what are the treatment plans done, what are the procedures done. So please do make a note your CSF, what is the CSF for tubercular meningitis, what is the CSF for your bacterial meningitis, what is CSF for your fungal mycology related or fungal related meningitis, and everything were discussed. Okay, which level is increased there, which level is decreased there, all these things. Okay, this is a case like where you can diagnose it as a herpes simplex virus, and what are the tests to be performed in this case were discussed again in the description, and what is the treatment plan done, and you're going to re-verify it again. So please do make a note about these things. Okay, CSF things which are there in your general medicine classes taken by the Pradhan sir. The next comes, I want to stress a few important things about the next, that is varicella zoster. So here a 50-year-old HIV positive, because I was talking in the previous slide that one of the common after herpes simplex, one of the common virus that you can see in HIV is varicella zoster. You can see in HIV patients. Okay, so here the case is 50 years old patient who is HIV positive, developed the eruptions on the right side of the spine in the lumbar region, which are very painful. Scraping from the base of the lesion were positive to herpes zoster antigen by direct fluorescence antibody test. A culture from the fluid was inoculated on cell line, and the PCR test was positive again for varicella zoster, and the patient was treated with acyclovir. On further inquiries, the patient revealed that the doctor has been on further inquiry the patient revealed to the doctor that he has chickenpox in the childhood. So it's very simple that he has chickenpox in the childhood, and where the chickenpox is going to reside in the ganglions. And again, during the weak condition, immunocompromised condition, your previously infections are going to be in the latent phase, and they are going to get reactivated. So HIV positive is something like what it's going to be. It's going to be an immunocompromised state. So your latent viruses which are residing in the ganglions are going to get activated. So they got activated, and the signs and symptoms are shown. So what happens in signs and symptoms? Then the next level, you have done some tests. One is direct fluorescence antibody test. One you have done, and second one you have sent to the PCR, because PCR is the most sensitive, and it's going to give the reactions. It's going to give the tests immediately. Then you got to conclude that it's the varicella zoster virus. Okay, confirmed the diagnosis. Then you have started the treatment by giving acyclovir. And I hope you are very clear with this particular condition or particular case. And do make a note about a varicella zoster chickenpox and the mode of ulcer is centripetal. So it's going to move towards the center. It is a centripetal in distribution. So centripetal in distribution, the rash is centripetal in distribution. And in these situations, regularly we give salicets, okay, for the patients, right? Salicets. So what happens when you give salicets for a patient of under a particular age of 12 years or something? So these salicets are going to react with the viral infections, and they're resulting in a formation of a syndrome called as Rice syndrome, which we learn in our NSAIDs discussion in case of your pharmacology. So that is an important thing that you have to make a note when I'm talking about this particular the disease. And other important thing that I want to make a note is Ramsay-Hunt syndrome. So Ramsay-Hunt syndrome is a rare form of zoster affecting the facial nerve, okay, with eruption on the tympanic membrane and external auditory canal, and often the facial palsy. Okay, so this is mainly you can see in the case of a zoster infection in combination with facial nerve paralysis. Okay, so please do make a note. Then next comes is one more, that is cytomegaly virus. So I'm going to tell one more case about the cytomegaly virus. The description is in front of you like this. Cytomegaly virus, a 25-year-old man diagnosed with HIV. Again, a HIV case. You can see cytomegaly virus infection also in the HIV patient. He's a 25-year male and HIV positive, and has been slowly progressive for the previous 3 years, complaints of a weight loss, and his CD4 count are less than 100, CD4 count are less than 100. On fundus examination, there were some infiltrations on the retinal surface of these, and with multiple hemorrhages you can see on the eye, in the eye, in the fundus. And the serological tests are positive. The serological tests are being done. They are positive. They are positive for CME. You have fundal, you have fundus lesions in the eye. The serological tests are positive for CMV, and the PCR also has confirmed that the patient is having the CMV. And the patient was treated in the same way as that of the previous viral infection. You have given ganaxolone, you have given to the patient. And further investigations related to the patient were done about the precautions to be taken or the medications to be followed for the anti-hepatitis. So this is what the case is. Okay, so these are the levels of like viral infection. They can give you a specific future. Okay, by for example, in the case of the previous discussion, they can ask you the syndrome. In that syndrome, they tell you that it's a viral infection, or they can give you the futures or signs of herpes zoster, and they can tell you the facial nerve futures. So by combination of these, you can conclude that that's a Ramsay-Hunt syndrome, right? Okay, the next comes or any other, you can add a note, ovale nucleus, ovuli, okay, are seen in the case of cytomegaly virus. And cytomegaly virus has to be taken into consideration very specifically when you're planning the treatment and the prevention. Prevention is indicated in high-risk cases such as organ transplants and immune-compromised individuals or prenatal infants. These are the people who are more susceptible to the infection caused by cytomegaly virus. And acyclovir is useful in the prophylaxis but not in the treatment. So what is the drug that is used in the treatment? So this is a drug that is useful for the treatment. Okay, but what is the drug that is useful for prevention is acyclovir. Is useful for the prevention. The next comes is Epstein-Barr virus, and most of you are familiar. Here the case is a 16 years girl with a complaint of loss of appetite and sore throat, fever of 40 degrees, raise in the temperature of 40 degrees, and especially in the evenings for the past 5 days. On examination, they have got to know cervical lymphadenopathy and mild hepatosplenomegaly, which is very specific to herpes zoster virus. And the patient has shown, got to know about abnormal mononuclear lymphocytosis, and the Pall Bunnell test was positive. Okay, so the Pall Bunnell test was considered to be positive in this case. And it is very specific to a particular molecule called as CD21. Do make a note about. So this was diagnosed as the Epstein-Barr virus. So things to be added, the source of infection is usually saliva infected from one patient to other patient. And this disease is also called as Kissing's disease. It occurs basically due to the deep kissing. It's called as Kissing disease. And Epstein-Barr virus is primarily concerned with the infective mononucleosis. The second one is, it is associated with Burkitt's lymphoma. It is associated with lymphoma in immune compromised individuals such as like AIDS or transplant cases. And it is main concerned with nasopharyngeal carcinoma in the case of in Chinese origin, that is specific to Chinese origin. And the next comes is, we have already discussed this, so why it is very specific to Chinese and everything on our groups during our regular discussion. The next comes is, it is seen in the case of Watten's tumor. It is seen in the case of many other diseases which we have learned. So you can stick on to that, and that is more than sufficient related to this Epstein-Barr virus. Okay, the tests of choice are the Pall Bunnell test. Okay, you're very familiar with it. And the other test you can use it is a heterophilic antibody test. Okay, so do make a note about this. And the type of HHV that is causing Kaposi's sarcoma is 8. Okay, HHV-8 is the primary source of occurrence of Kaposi's sarcoma. So do make a note about this diphtheria. Diphtheria, the pseudomembrane is very tough and leathery, and it is very difficult to remove. So diphtheria organisms are also called as, okay, do make a note. So this is again a question that is given in one of the examinations. So please do make a note, make it on diagram based questions. Okay, then comes this particular test, which is very specific to a particular bacterial infection. Okay, so it is positive for diphtheria. So please do make a note about this this test. Okay, of course, again, this can be asked as a diagram based question. String of pearls, and I hope like most of you know these terms and bacterial names, but now in an examination like NEET, they're trying to link everything with the diagram. So I hope like we are well familiar with all this stuff which is there in your PP books, and we have discussed so many times in our regular classes. So please do string of pearls. Okay, again, this reaction, you're very familiar with this reaction, but a diagram based question, how well you can handle a diagram based question. Okay, the next comes the media, which is useful for, what is the diagram of H. pyrrole? Very specific organism for the peptic ulcer. What is a specific test? Urea's test is very specific to identify them. Transport media, which is useful for Kerala. Plummer-Vinson syndrome, very familiar. What is this? Iron deficiency anemia, glossitis, spoon-shaped nails. It's most familiar to post-cricoid web in esophagus, carcinoma of esophagus. What is the treatment can be done? Barium meal can be taken from these individuals. What are the other names? Plummer-Vinson syndrome, Patterson-Killis syndrome, Patterson's-Brown-Killis syndrome, pseudophytic dysplasia, the vector which is going to cause this, Lyme disease, what are the symptoms and signs you can see, what is Wheal's disease, a serious form of leptospirosis, what are the other features of leptospirosis, you can see R3 in leptospirosis, what is that, rat, rice field, and rainfall. What is this test useful for? So please do make a note of all this stuff. What is this group of organisms? H stands for, A stands for, C, E, K. Regularly asked question, most common areas of question. Cat scratch disease, they can give a description. They can ask you the organism which is responsible for cat scratch disease. Okay, so please do make a note about this new terminology of disease. Where you can see this is a particular test, whereas it's a gelatin capsule test which is very specific to this particular parasite. Okay, again, this is a diagram based question that you have to make a note. Okay, the appearance. String test is again a test that is useful for endodontic root canal sealer mixing. It should be more than one inch. What is the difference between the gonococci and meningococci? All these are discussed in your regular sessions, regular classes. Very important. What is this Waterhouse syndrome? Other names. And of course, this is a question that is again given in the recent AIIMS, if I'm not wrong. So LA, this is the doses of concentration of adrenaline. Anaphylactic shock, IM, this is the doses. SC, this is the doses. For example, if you're going with IV anaphylactic shock, this is the doses. Cardiac arrest and bronchial asthma. What is the treatment for status epilepticus? What are the uses of beta blockers? You can remember this name. These are the uses of beta blockers. And a mnemonic for gram-positive bacteria. So this is the mnemonic for gram-positive bacteria. You're done for now. Done with part 2 of your micro and a bit on medicine, case-based approach. So the logic is very simple. Try to identify the keyword. The keyword is going to give you the conclusion where you can eliminate easily two options. So you'll be left over with two more, and how your skills and abilities are an ineffective two options. For example, if the paper setter like me is very cool, will not keep more confusion or overlapping options. Okay. So that you can conclude the answer easily. If they want to make it too tricky to filter the students who has better capability of selecting the best treatment option or best options among the two, they may give a tricky options which overlaps by two. So that leads to a bit confusion. So how to handle that confusion is your presence of mind in the examination hall is one point that is going to decide everything in judging an answer. So even the questions are prepared in such a way that there will be one point. Until that point, you will be left over with two options. That one key point is going to decide what is the right answer. So if you are not in a position to identify that key point and conclude the right answer, then it's going to be tricky that you'll be end up with two options. Okay. So this is what the issue with most of the students. But anyway, stay positive. Your presence of mind and your self-belief, okay, and your confidence levels that I can do the best as of now, or I can give you the best shot in the examination hall is going to decide everything. Stay positive. God bless you. Love you all. Signing off, Dr. Srikanth from Team MDS Concur.